Now, as you heard earlier, Miranda Ntshangase is quite a soulful singer and a songwriter whose angelic voice will leave you mesmerised, with no doubt. Now, some of you might notice that her face looks quite familiar. Well, that's because she has graced our small screens on some of Mzansi's hit soapies, ranging from SABC One's Tshisa, Sokhulu and Partners, ETV's Rhythm City, and most recently portraying the character of Joy on The Queen. But today, she's here to talk about her debut single, Lendoda. And Miranda says the song is about the day she met her husband of 11 years, and she's in studio with us this morning to tell us more. Very good morning to you, Miranda. Thank you so much for joining us and welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
Indeed. Now, Lendoda is about love. So do you actually enjoy writing about love songs?
I do. I think love, any musician loves writing about intense emotions. Mm-hmm. And one of the intense emotions that people love hearing the most about is love.
Yeah.
You know. So when I wrote the song, I was extremely in love.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Love is such a beautiful thing.
It
I
is.
Can tell you that. And what urged you to write this song?
You know, when I met my husband, it was an out-of-body experience, and I know it sounds cliche. So when I met him, I wanted to write about it so that I can tell how I met him and what an incredible man he is till today,
yeah.
You know. So that was mainly the urge for me. It was to share my story with other people. And that's what songwriting is, really, to share your stories with other people.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. The song that you just performed earlier, I could pick jazz beats. I could pick, Afro soul. What exactly, how would you say describe your music?
It's a mixture of African sounds, mm-hmm, with a bit of jazz and with a bit of soul. So
yeah,
a lot of people would call it Afro soul.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure. Now, what does your husband think about your music and your musical career and about all the songs that you
He's
write?
Amazing. He's actually my engineer. So he actually prepared the backtracks for me last night,
wow,
very late into the night. So he helps me through it all and he supports me.
Mm.
Yeah.
Did he learn anything about you from this song?
I don't know. We'd have to ask him.
All right. So what do you look forward to in your career as you maneuver around the industry?
Just to live my best life of my dreams, you know. I want to share stories and I want to share what's happening in my life and other people's life, because I don't just write about my own stories. I think any artist or any creative wants to know that their stories are received well or their art is received well, and that's ultimately what I wish for.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I know you fell into acting and then music came along. So what sort of lessons have you learned as an actor before venturing into music?
Acting teaches you quite a lot.
Yeah.
Confidence,
sure,
is one of them. Being able to speak to people with an open face and an,
sure,
open smile so that people receive you well, you know.
Sure.
There's a lot of things that acting has prepared me for in terms of my music right now.
And how do you juggle both acting, music and family life?
It is very tricky. I also run two businesses at the same,
whoa,
time. So it's very tricky. Sometimes I don't make it, sometimes I do. But it is what it is. I take each day at a time and then I just tackle one day.
Mm-hmm.
And then I see the rest later.
Talk to us about how Lion King led you to make music. What was the inspiration towards it?
So Lion King, when I was really, really young, oh my gosh, I can't believe you know that. I'm very shocked by that question. That's so easy, did your research. I didn't know I could sing, and I went to an art school, and I think my passion was more for painting and acting in the beginning. Mm-hmm. And then my headmaster happened to walk past the bathroom while I was singing a Lion King song. I just heard the choir sing it and I was like, oh my gosh, this is a beautiful song.
Mm-hmm.
But I was just singing, it wasn't anything fancy, you know. And then he waited for me until I came out of the bathroom,
yeah,
and said to me, you are going to the choir now. And I was like, oh,
get out of here.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
So I went to the choir and then I tried it out and I was really, really scared because I didn't know how to sing.
Mm.
And then at the end of the session, he said to me, you know what, I want to mentor you, and so that you can start your classical music lessons,
oh, wow,
and music lessons, so I can just mentor you. And I am the musician I am today because,
wow,
of my headmaster.
Wow, go figure. All right, now, as a final question, what sort of message does your music portray? What is it that you want me as a listener of your music to learn or to know about what you do?
That is a very tricky question. I think ultimately it's just stories and for people to learn from,
okay,
other people's stories, you know?
Okay.
And the goodness of music.
Yeah.
You know, I miss the days where you could listen to music and the content of the music is good. And it's positive and it's uplifting. All of that stuff, you know. I'd love to take music back to that. And I'm not saying I'm single-handedly going to take this task on. But I would love for people to get back.
Such a mammoth task, though.
Yeah, it is, right? Mm. I was speaking with two other ladies the other day about it that I'm doing a show with on the 11th at Winnie's Jazz Club. Mm-hmm. And we were talking about how we would love for people to get back to jazz and Afro soul and good music.
Okay.
And that's ultimately what we want.
When should we expect your first album?
Hopefully next year sometime. I'm hoping maybe like mid-March, April, around there.
We certainly cannot wait. Miranda, great chatting to you.
Thank you so
much.
All
the best in music.
Thank
you. We love it.
Thank
you. You've got an angelic voice.
Thank you. I appreciate
it. If I have to say it so myself. All right. That is Miranda Ntshangase's song, Lendoda, is available on iTunes or Google Play and other digital platforms now. Stay tuned to Morning Live to hear more from this talented vocalist. Well, Morning Live takes a coffee break. We'll be right back. Hakiba te usala ntle thuso.